Hello and welcome to Zach Miller 3 TV, and yes, it is Championship 4 race. Today in the booth I got Dark Extreme with me. First we're going to go over our Championship 4 and their stats. I'm going to go ahead and start off. So, we have four drivers. Let's go over Sumdan. Roach Racing, number 63, Dodge, has gathered up 2 wins this season, all of which coming late, and has led a total of 31 laps to the season, 4 top 5s, 10 top 10s, and 3 poles. And
Silver Fox with 3 wins, led 15 laps, 6 top 5s, and 12 top 10s with 1 pole.
And then we got Brock Nelson, probably the least calculated best driver of our Champ 4. He only has 1 win compared to everyone else, so has multiple. He has 51 laps led, however, which is most of everyone else. He has 3 top 5s, 7 top 10s, and he doesn't have any poles this season, but nonetheless, has put together his way into the Champ 4.
At least Zigzagoon with 2 wins, 24 laps led, 8 top 5s, and 14 top 10s, with only 1 pole left to his name.
Dark on that. That's our Championship 4 that are going to be racing for a championship here today. We're going to go to the race here in just a second. And welcome back. We are here at the racetrack now, and Tufty Terror is taking the pole, though it looks like he is out in the outside lane. The pole sitter goes to the outside driver because this is a right turn oval, so that is how this game works with that. Again, we got four drivers racing for a championship today. Dark Extreme in the booth. You got any first thoughts to start off with this event?
Yeah, but the last race of the season is staying off the 2023 year. And so far, Sixflix is, okay, Sundan is our leading playoff driver. It's easier to take advantage of the qualifying section. As our second highest, I believe, is going to be Brandon Nelson. And he will have work to do. He's frustrating a good old Red Bull car. Then he can find his way into the championship. But he had to get... But he has some work to do. Speaking of work to do, our other two guys in the back, featuring Saber Fox, who has 3 wins of the season, hopefully the end of the season with a nice cup championship for his team. And then last and not least, our fourth playoff driver of the day, Zigzagoon. See, he's wondering if he can take on a championship. But he got a long way to get there. As for others who will be either coming back for next season or looking for other teams, although the list is very long and short at this moment.
Yep. Yeah, this will be a very important race for a lot of guys, some of them being probably their last NCCRS race, some being their last NCCRS race with a specific team. A lot of end-of-the-line stuff coming here today. 40 laps to cap off the end of our NCCRS season. I do believe it's been a pretty good one so far, and hopefully next year we capitalize and do even better.
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure this field is going to be more stacked than ever. I don't know if it's going to be either a cap for it, or would it be expanded onto the next?
Well, the next season the cap's actually going to be lower. It's going to be 42 cars instead of 46. Same will go for Cup, 42 instead of 46, and if needed, we will start a third division, but that'll be discussed later on, as needed.
But I guarantee the offseason is going to be busy when this series is over.
Yep, might take me a
while. But there is some who found the new teams already doing the regular season.
Yep.
Because I think Nimrod is going to Roach Racing, I think.
Wick Rare Racing,
Rare Racing.
Based on the announcement I've seen. Ferris is starting off in the top five today. Unfortunately, I got eliminated from the round of eight last week, but still a stellar season for that 29 car. Best season they've had.
Oh, yeah. Well, sure, a good season that they're going on to new adventures to another team. As I think others... I don't know who else is going to be moving on to a new team. Can I think confirm Frank is going to be moving up to Cup?
Oh, that's not really confirmed, but... Still got a sign-ups thing to go through, but... Nonetheless, 40 laps, got a lot of guys and stuff going, new teams and stuff. I probably won't be changing too much until... a couple weeks after the Cup season, Cup Series Championship race, just to ease into our off season and whatnot. It looks like looks like the 55 may have some tire damage from, according to the radio, they're reporting some issues that might be wrong with their tire. So keep an eye on Ryan Cole in the 55, as we'll get this thing on the road. About 15 seconds to the command to start our final race of the season. Hopefully it's smoother than what we had in the spring. I did ease some things out. We'll just hope for the best.
And not only that, this is the farewell season for Pontiac, and this is their last race in the CCS as well.
Drivers, start your engines!
Man's been given. We have 45 cars making the start today. Four of them battling for a championship. Does not matter how close they are to each other, how many points are gained, how many laps are led. How many, whatever they've done all race, whoever finishes higher than the other will be crowned the champion, regardless of the circumstance. I feel like I shouldn't have said that, but here we are. Pacing's a little weird at this track. Don't mind that.
Well, Carsland Super Speedway is the widest track of the circuit.
Just realized,
so we will have stuff like this happen once in a while.
I just realized I forgot to turn on my Better Cautions DXC, so I'll have to be careful doing that, because sometimes if I'm not careful, I'll crash the game. Restart violations are kind of be easy at this track, since the pace is so far apart. It's only if they're I'll just kind of have to eyeball it to guess restart violations. Initial starts of the race usually don't lead to that. We're underway here at Cars Lane. Hopefully, we make it through lap one. Oh, we don't.
Turn number one yet, and we already have a caution. But a question needed.
And Zig Zagoon on the. That's not how you want to start it. That, what a joke. Ah, man.
Zig Zagoon, Frank, and I think there's some more.
I think Frank was only. I think Zigzagoon was the only playoff guy involved. Yeah, we talked about just being overly aggressive. It looked like the four just dove it in deep. So, just to be safe, we're going to be continuing with single file starts. This championship race can't be risking any more playoff drivers.
Toledo's in it. Fontana got a piece of it.
Zigzagoon had nowhere to go.
Right, yeah, it can hit the brakes in time. Look like it's like five cars involved.
Two playoff drivers. Unfortunately, that's going to be Zig Zagoon's championship hopes. Right on the, not even
Nelson.
Lap in. So we're going to continue here with single file starts.
I don't know what Brooke Nelson is all.
So that's not where I was one. So there's Frank Chilton. So who's the leader now? The track's very spread out. Racing back's weird. So it looks like they've raced back, and look how many spots Tufty Terror has lost.
Not only that, Sundan also lost a whole bunch of spots as well.
I mean, one driver they don't have to worry about now is Zig Zagoon, and Brock Nelson much less of a concern or a threat for that matter. He's got a little bit of damage. Still running.
But is it enough to affect them on speed and aerodynamics? That is the question.
Yep. And then
otherwise, they're going to go down to Saber Fox and Sundan. Right now,
championship leader at the moment, I believe, is Saber Fox. They're still trying to file where they need to be. As we're still under the other light. Yeah, it looks like Saber Fox is currently the championship leader at the moment. They're still trying to file out where they need to be.
Has everyone followed the pace car?
Looks like everyone getting plenty of room, which is good. And there will not be double file starts for two reasons. One, I forgot to turn on my EXE for that. And two, because big race, don't want to risk it. And I'm just going to, like, pray we don't have a overtime yellow. The odds of that happening is kind of slim in a track like this. But we'll see.
Well, a lot of those guys are battling for the achievement. Yeah, we're going to see.
We hate to see Zigzagoon. He's not going to be able to continue, as unfortunately it looks like Michael Guerrero and Frank Chilton got together lap one. Not what you want to do. And cost each other the race. And I'm just going to go ahead and say that was a dumb move on both drivers' parts. Unfortunately, it cost Zigzagoon. But Zigzagoon kind of plowed into that. He could have slowed down a little bit better. So we're down to a three-car battle now for the championship. But hopefully that was a one-and-done incident, and we can keep this thing going.
On a bright side, there's no one officially out.
I don't believe that's true. I believe the 55, I know, is had tire damage, and they're currently repairing that. But I think the 06 is done. They had some very serious damage.
Likely
they're done for the day. They're still technically in it, but they're like, and same for Frank Chilton. They've been in the pit road for quite a bit now. However, they still, you know, get finishing points. But at this rate, for Zigzagoon, his championship hopes are dashed pretty much. Even if he does get that repaired, he's going to be several laps off the pace, and there's just no hope.
Not even one lap, and we end up with an incident like that.
I think everyone's good. We should be good to go green next time. Again, I'm not going to be too overzealous with the AI, especially on cautions and stuff, because I know this track's a little janky.
So we should be going green probably, in the next.
It looks like Patrick Miller, surprisingly, is done for the day. He was probably involved in that.
Oh, so it's not Victor Nunez.
He had some heavy damage in that wreck. He went ahead and went to pit road. So LJ Toledo. So we'll go ahead and go to... So the pace car is going to be going in this time. Again, the pacing's a little weird, I believe. The lead has been assumed by a Potato Boy, so he's going to get some season standings here. He was actually kind of close to the thing. So he's not out of the discussion for, you know, some, like, top... five, maybe top 10. Top 10 finishing standings, which I think he's already in that ballpark. So, just a good way to end your season. He's a pretty good one. Two wins and almost a championship four bid.
Yep, so we should be going green on lap number 5.
Yep, as we didn't even get one lap in. Unfortunate. So, they're going to be single file here, so if they screw this up, I'm disappointed, honestly. It'd be a fight survive, but something we don't really want to see, especially when it's a playoff championship decider here at the Carsland Super Speedway. And I think for just... it looks like... Oh, yeah, I forgot. With my EXE not on, the lap cars will be up front.
Ryan Cole?
So he's going to get the free pass on the start anyway, because he's the only car lap down, I believe, that's still in it. He's actually two laps.
He's two laps now, so he's going to be fighting to get one of his laps back.
I'll let him fight.
Now official that the 6 is officially out. Let's see the retirement.
Yeah, unfortunately, Zigzagoon had a stellar season for that 06 car. Won't be able to.
The only downside about Ryan Cole that since he's the only car to two laps down, he's not going to have any drafting help, so you may stay two laps down.
Thought we were going to go green the last time by, but I guess they delayed it to this time. I'm not sure the reason for that.
I think now we get the one to go signal.
We do now. I'm not sure why it wasn't there before. But,
so the 55 is actually one lap down.
That might have been a scoring thing. We'll see what happens. But, again, hopefully we get some good green flag runs going and no more yellows. That'd be nice.
So, I don't know how
This is actually a lighter setup than what we had for the spring race. It was already smoother to start because they didn't have a wreck in the start. We were talking before.
Yeah, I don't know.
There was a 50-50 chance that someone was going to wreck on the start, and 50% swayed all the way. And unfortunately, caught up one of the, actually two of the championship four drivers, but one of them unfortunately won't be able to defend their bid for that.
So at the moment, it's going to go down either Saber Fox or Sundance, since they have a little bit of an advantage for having the best car. But a trick like this, anything is possible. So I wouldn't count on Brooke Nelson out.
And hopefully we get to the green flag run long enough to where we see some of these guys just fan out, and we have some, per se, spread out racing to who has the faster cars and who has the better speed, who preserves their stuff. And all that good jazz. I do not believe everyone has to pit. We did see some guys pit there. I'm not sure if all of it was for damage, but I believe most of it was. Base car goes in this time. And restart violations will not be handed out due to our single file restart rule. That'll be continued throughout the race, just to ensure we don't have any more crashes. And hopefully, we don't. Oh, a few cars didn't go.
Well, there we go.
A few cars did not have that great of a start, but I think once we get all the kinks figured out, everyone is good to go in turn one. Go to spectator cam.
Yeah, as soon as Brooke Nelson's by himself, we're going to go back two laps now.
Yeah, that 55. So let's see. Plenty of room in that 55 car.
Yeah, he don't have any help, so he's going to fall way back. But so far, the battle for the lead is between Potato Boy and... Actually, I want your tail now, because they're all fanned out. Fox is now your leader. And I think our lead playoff driver right now is... I believe it's... I'm going to say Saber Fox.
So Saber Fox, before he crossed the line, I believe he still holds that. He was a 26.
Let's see.
We'll see when he crossed the line, I'm not sure.
Let's see.
Yeah, it looks like Sumdan actually did get around him, and so did, where's Brock Nelson? Brock Nelson's actually back here. He's not as quick right now. So, yeah, right now Sumdan in the 63.
Ooh, a bit bumped the jet, though. There's Sumdan.
Yeah, we can't be bumping around.
It's currently 25th.
We may have to, the 43 continues going in and out of pit row. We may have to go ahead and disqualify him for just being in the way as a lapped car.
Well, let's see how this is going to work out.
I don't know if it'll work, but actually, let me try this. I know this is more of an online thing, but let me try it. Yeah, there it goes. And he hasn't came in and out yet, so.
Let's see.
But yeah, this 51 right now, not on pace where he needs to be. I'm not sure if he got any cataclysmic damage there in that crash. But definitely is not up to pace with his other two competitors for the championship four.
I wonder how many seconds behind he is compared to everyone else.
LJ Toledo's losing quite a bit of time, so that's going to be a DQ. And so, same going to be, well, you know, we know the 43 came into the pits, but we know the 04 didn't. Otherwise, it would have said in chat.
It looks like somebody pit it. 43, okay.
Unfortunately for LJ Toledo, I'm going to have to call him to the pits, and same for the...
Michael O.
Yeah, Michael Giro. We just got his three-car draft back here. Call me crazy. Hey, call me dumb. Battle of the mid. The 07-71. Not really top-tier drivers. Neither is Brock Nelson either, but how's a win this season? And he's battling for a championship, but... unfortunately with the damaged car. So at this rate for Brock, he's going to hope that the 87 and 63 have some issues. And with this green flag run we have right now, not sure how long it's going to last. And hopefully it lasts, in my opinion. We could see those guys go lap down.
Yeah, that's going to make a mistake. I don't think I'm seeing any cautions either.
Yeah.
Because I think it's going to be between Sundan and Saber Fox. Speaking of those two, let's see where they're at now.
Sundan currently
there's
20th.
Sundan.
At the line, and Saber Fox is currently in 32nd. Not really up there where they want to be.
So right now, Sundan's in the championship clinching position. But these guys are definitely running different lines.
They're still trying to figure out. Some are saving a little bit of tires, just to gun at the end. We'll see how these lines and whatnot figure out towards the end of this race. It's like Noah Clifton up there currently leading the race. But again, these guys just trying to figure out where they want to be and how they want to do what they're going to be running for the end of this thing. And there's a reason why this track has so many lanes. It's because I built the track and I didn't know what I was doing. So yeah, there's your answer.
So many lanes mean so many different driver lines. Some may take the high lane, some may take the low lane. Others may take the middle, if you can call it that. But hey, it's Carlin Super Speedway. Each position is going to change in every corner.
I've seen so many positions far back. It looks like Ryan Cole able to compete up here with these cars. So in the instance we do get another yellow, he is at, granted he won't be on the lead lap, but he will be getting at least one of his laps back and have better closer bid to, you know, maybe having some competition with cars that are slower than he. He does have a little bit of side damage as well. I think he might have gotten involved in that accident despite coming to the pit road to get the repairs on the tire he had issues with, which I think it was.
This is good for Sundan because he's in the first pack compared to where Sarah Fox is. I think he's in the second or third pack of cars. So as long as you stay instead of Sarah Fox, he pretty much got it.
Yeah, at this rate, Sarah Fox isn't even in a pack. He's kind of a lone ranger right now, which is. The further back of the pack you are like that, I think the worse off you are, but we'll see how this race goes. I'm not entirely sure if they have to pit or not. That is something I'm not sure of.
Yeah, this is not what Silver Fox wants to see. You're not in the draft or anyone they have yet, then. You're pretty much in the sucker hole. Are they trying to get around Nimrod for 33rd, I believe?
Nimrod, one of those drivers,
and
that's
for
a championship four bid. Just didn't quite have enough there at the end, and it's still a stellar season for that 29 car.
Yep, as Nimrod is kind of her last season for Dynamotor Motorsports, as she will move on to Rick Ware Racing. At least on a high note. But running 33rd, probably not.
Yeah.
At least
still a great season.
Probably still out of trouble. Yeah, she had a great season. And then her battles for NC is intense.
Who?
So right now, who's our current leader?
I have no idea. Because it rotates so much between Victor Nunez and the 20 currently leading. He's actually got, well, no, never mind. He's actually already been passed.
I guess he was in the lead, but he got passed in the corner.
And he got passed by Marker Leonard, who won a race this season, and Matthew Hill, who also has won a race this season. Marker Leonard, however, he's only ran a few races. He's joined late in the season, whereas Matthew Hill, he's been in since 2021, finally got his first career win. At Homestead, Miami. Funny enough, his home track.
Ooh, what a run by Matthew Hill. He's gonna try to pass on the high side.
This is working. He's only a lane higher. He's gonna try to get the exit. I don't know how well that's gonna work because this track is kind of weird, kind of goofy. But we'll see. As this race goes on, we know the tire wear is going to get a little bit more. And we're going to see drivers maybe try different lanes. We see they're not diving down in the corners as they were at the beginning of this run. They're kind of going, leaving a little bit of room down there because there's no grass down there. The only thing protecting you from the racing surface in the wall is literally nothing. You have to just kind of find your line between that racing surface and the wall, whereas most tracks, you have a grass or something there that kind of prevents you from maximizing time, whereas this track, you kind of just press the limits, and most of these guys know what they're doing in that aspect, and they're being not only very careful with that, but they're also trying that higher line just to not use up their tires as much. Whereas Marco Leonard, he's going a little bit lower. I think he's using up his tires more, but it really depends on how he's racing the track. That 66 Roach Racing Dodge teammate to Sumdam, by the way.
Yeah, but that's the thing where the track you are, because some areas you can gain a lot of time, but others you can lose a lot of time as well.
Yep, 100%.
So far, guys are slowly getting spread out. Like, first, second, and third are about almost 3-4 car lengths different from each other. And we see Alex Tanker, who's currently third. As he looking at the end of the season, at least with a top five.
Running for his own team this year. Decided, tried running for Trackhouse last year, didn't quite work out for him. They couldn't really agree on a few things, so he decided to start his own operation, and so far, not so bad. Two wins of the season, and had a pretty solid year. Almost made it to the round of 12. I believe he did make the playoffs. I might be mistaken, but if he didn't, he was pretty close. At least it felt like it, if I remember correctly.
Speaking of Trickhouse Racing, I don't know how many drivers I have at this point, but character alignment with Wild Wolf Motorsports is probably gone.
Well, we know one of their cars is out of the two of their cars are out of the race. Patrick Miller and LJ Toledo. They still have the 48 Eric Monaco, and I believe Michael. Actually, no, Michael Garrow also out of the race. So they only have those two cars, as their other three have already out of the race, and three out of the four cars out of the race, and only six cars out of the race. That's half the cars out of the race are on that team. That's not great. So Eric Monaco, the only Trackhouse racing car still in the race, and not running too great really right now.
And he's currently ahead of one of our championship drivers,
Sabre Fox.
Currently, gaining a couple of spots. Went from 33rd to 30th, so Sarah Fox is slowly making his way to the front.
He was able to get around Melinda Jones and Nimrod.
Yeah, and I think, see where Sundan is. He is currently 20th, so might be more now, because I think we have a battle between Sundane and Sabre Fox. If this keeps up. As a matter of fact, we can see him in the... You see a little bit of an orange speck once you get into the corner. You can definitely see where Sundane is. Well, not Sundane, Sabre Fox. And Sabre Fox is slowly coming to the front.
Those
not what Sundan wants
close
to see.
They're getting closer.
Oh, yeah.
Sundan is starting to lose a few spots.
Sundan is losing spots while Sarah Fox is slowly starting to gain.
Yeah, it ain't over yet. And also, we're halfway when we cross the stripe this time around.
Matter of fact, I think Sarah Fox can see Sundan if we through the... As our leader is now Marker Leonard.
He's still in the lead. He was pulled off Matthew Hill.
Oh, yeah. We can see where... Now we on Six Flames, aka Sundown. He's down to... Yeah, he's losing a lot of spots. It's an 8-spot difference between Sundan and Silverfox.
Currently 8. Well, he got around Eric Monaco again there for the crossover from a couple laps ago. Now 9 spots separate the lead championship 4 drivers. Now, these next round of lap cars are not off pace enough to get disqualified from the race. So they will actually be a factor in this, depending on how much of a factor they're willing to put themselves into. Brock Nelson could play the riskiest, in my opinion, but again, you don't want to be stupid and cost yourself something that already seems to be gone, especially in Brock Nelson's case.
Don't look at the moment now, but that orange speck is getting larger and larger.
That orange speck is getting pretty big.
A little orange speck of Silver Fox. And you can see him literally in the... The orange speck is right there. I think it's maybe an 8 or 7 car difference now.
Well, last time across the line it was 8 car difference. Let's see how it updates here.
Let's see, because right now Sundan is currently 22nd.
And that was up compared to Silver Fox.
Yeah. Currently 22nd, but you can definitely see Saber Fox's. You can see his car definitely going there. So let's see.
We're
across the line now.
25th, only 5 spots separate them now. And Saber Fox,
still 30th.
And well, actually, it looks like Sandy Messi might be working on him, or vice versa. I'm not sure. Now past halfway.
Yeah, the championship challenge is gonna getting closer and closer. I don't know what Silver Fox found in that car, but he definitely found something.
Well, I don't think he's found anything. He's still running 30th place. This is not great at all by either of these drivers. Very poor performance by all four championship 4 drivers, but Sumdan is really just losing a lot of pace right now. 25th right now on the track is the highest running playoff driver. That's the lower half of the field. That's insane. And they still hold 35th. It looks like Saber Fox actually lost a spot that time around to Aztec Lovett. So he's now 6 cars separate the two.
Yeah, there's something happening to... Something's going on with Sunday, man. Could he not where he qualified?
No, he qualified up there in, like, 3rd.
Even though Silver Fox is in the 30th position, Sundan has lost a whole bunch of spots.
Saber Fox was started a lot better than this as well. They started around where Sundan's running right now.
I think Saber Fox started with Brandon Nelson. Oh, well, not Saber Fox, Zig Zagoon, before an incident happened on the first lap.
Brock Nelson, he's
currently 27th, so...
Yeah, that just goes to show. I mean, the gap between the championship field is pretty even right now, but it's pretty even in the back. And Brock Nelson is not competitive right now with these guys. And it could be damage. It could be that they didn't have enough time to pass enough draft to get any closer to cars. But they had some sort of pace to drive around, and it could be anything. And at this rate, if they go a lap down here, their hopes are pretty much dashed.
That was 16 laps to go. So far, the battle is between Sundan and Silver Fox. And at the moment, Sundan is holding, well, getting the spot up to 24th. And Silver Fox is now 30th, so it's still a kind of 5-car difference.
Change. It looks like we see something in the track. It looks like the 17 of the... Byron Webb appears to have an oil leak in that 17 car. He's probably going to have to go on pit road here soon to repair that. And he's running in 5th right now, so not what he wants to see. So they're going to try to stay on the track as long as they can. Unfortunately, having a great run. Unfortunately, he's going to... Oh, and they're already having issues. Oh, crash!
And
end of the
caution.
25! End of the wall!
That was the worst place of all tire.
Right in front of the 25.
And the 25 is, I think it's Williams.
Caden Williams is the 25. Byron Webb from 5th has crashed. Caden Williams is done for the day as well in that 25 car. We noticed in the chat he had the oil leak. And unfortunately, it came around right there. Nothing he could do. He was trying to. He could have stayed on the track. Not much he could have did here. Right in front of Alex Tanker, who was running well. It looks like Marker Leonard may have lost the lead somewhere in this round of something.
Yeah, you can feel he was trying to go low, but he just wasn't fast enough to get there. And then the 25 just had nowhere to go.
There was Alex Tanker.
Riley Gore somehow splits the middle.
Yeah, Riley Gore's trying to end this season with
that
the win.
Was.
He was running well, 7th, and now I think he got 5th after that. Who's the leader? Because we know it's not Leonard. Looks like
he's on the 57.
Our Kansas sweep driver, Sam Hoskin, is taking the lead as Pox Cozart and Matthew Hill still up here. Let's go back to live coverage, and everyone's coming down to pit road. This is going to be the money stop. Question now is, can everyone come down pit road and not have any issues that would catastrophically affect the race and ruin it? Lucky Dog will go to the, the 71, I think, did go a lap down, so the 55 will not be able to get their lap back as they would have hoped, but unfortunately the 71 is going to get that. The Tough Terror takes that number one. Pox Cozart with a stellar stop. Sam Oskin gets it, and everyone else coming out of pit road pretty smoothly right now. Some Dan just coming in. The battle now is between Some Dan and
Saber Fox.
It looks like Someday is going to get it over him. Brock Nelson still in it as well. Where is Saber Fox? Actually, Saber Fox may have snuck out over Brock Nelson, so he might actually be competitive. We don't know. So
someone did the DNF.
Saber Fox, where is he? I didn't see him. What happened to Saber Fox? Oh my, what happened? What?
So, Moon, wait a minute. What is it on pit road?
Did they wreck under yellow?
This might have been. Yeah, this had happened during yellow. Something did happen.
Someone wrecked under yellow.
That was. Let's see.
Someone flipped.
Oh, dear.
Alright, well, it's official. We're not using this track anymore.
Well, it was a pileup. And it looked like it was.
Some did somehow avoided it.
Is that Thunder 4 fan? Well.
Yeah, that's 24 fan. That's
Thunder 4 fan.
What happened?
And it also had whoa. So
okay,
it's not over yet. And it looks like Sundan was involved in this as well.
He got some rear end damage. Exactly the same amount of rear end damage that Brock Nelson has. That makes things interesting.
Well, there's still a chance from Brandon Nelson then.
Yeah, and there's only three cars between them at this point. Well, that was about as catastrophic as I didn't want. It's official. We're not.
Yeah, it happens under caution too.
This track is getting blacklisted.
So the battle is going to be between Sundan and Brendan Nelson, since Sarah Fox has been in an accident under yellow. So instead of the championship 4, it's down to the championship 2. Well, Brooke Nelson, I should say, not Brandon Nelson.
Circumstances, yeah. That's not what I wanted to see. Yikes.
And sadly, the dashes is over for Saber Fox at the end of his or her season.
This track is not going to be used at all anymore in either series. Tried fixing it, tried doing everything I could. It's not fixable. We're trashing it. But we'll go ahead and end this. Hopefully, we'll have something.
The battle not over yet. We thought Brendan Nelson's going to be out. Now he has a chance, thanks to that incident.
Definitely so. And then
may not be possible way for the race to go, but at least none of our championship drivers are out, besides two.
We're not going here. Really messed it up.
With 12 laps to go, and I guess Baton gets the whip around, or that is how that work again?
Baton gets the whip around. Let me go ahead and just do that.
I guess how that works.
If he's even still in the race, I don't even know if he's still in the race. Did he survive all that? Yeah,
there he goes.
He's still in it. hate that happened. Actually, you know what? I think next year we're going to put the championship race up to a vote. Now, granted, next year we're on a different point system, so it's possible next year we see champion clinched before the season ends. So that'll be something, but I said it once here, I'll say it again. This track is blacklisted. In fact, I may even consider changing this track for the cup race. And furthermore, I will ensure our EXE is on to make sure collisions under yellow is off. And I will ensure that, as well as making sure all the cars are lined up. That way we don't have a issue we had like last year where playoff driver went inside another driver and engulfed each other. So for the cup race, I'm going to have our BC EXE on. We're going to have single file starts just because this track sucks. And we're going to turn off the changeability of the cars during yellows to make sure that don't happen again. And keep our lap cars at the back. And do what we should have done in the beginning here. Live and learn, and hopefully don't make the same mistakes twice.
And that's the way you want to end the championship race. But hey, with literally 11 laps to go, going down to 10 to go.
Pox Kozar has a chance to do something I don't believe has ever been done in the history of this entire league, and that is, you know what? I don't know if that would go true for Cup, but I know it would go true here for NCCRS. Close out the season by sandwiching the races, meaning he would win. He's won race one of the season, might as well win the last one. He hasn't won a race in between. He has the chance to do that today. We'll see if he can clutch.
You mean win at the beginning while winning in the last race? As we're now? Well, I guess that's one way to restart the race, but hey.
Yeah, it's just how they do it. Go ahead and go.
9 laps to go. We're so wise for the lead. And I think that is the... No, I don't know who's at the bottom. But there is your leader. Then we'll switch over again.
I believe it is...
They lost a lot of spots.
We know Ryan Cole is not on the lead lap. But he's currently in first. We know he's not on the lead lap, though. It looks like Tufty Terror or Pole Sitter trying to take it back.
Ooh, 51. We got Monster. We have...
Monster's on the lead
lap. Moon Man.
I don't see movement.
That's about we have Lurf. And I think our... Let's see, where's Sundan and... Sundan and Nelson at
right
the moment.
Right next to each other.
Oh, boy.
Battle
this is going to just... As I said earlier, it's going to go down to these two. That may not...
Heading to right now. With this... circumstances like this, then running currently last right now, I'm not gonna DQ them. I think they're close enough to field anyway.
Well, 8 laps to go. It's the championship 2 between Sundan and Brook Nelson.
Yeah, I mean, I think we can say it would have came down to Sundan anyway, but Brock Nelson's in the fight, and he's actually in the fight now. We were saying his championship might be dashed if he went a lap down, and unfortunately that 17 car kind of threw us in a downward spiral. I will say, the 63 has a little bit more rear-end damage than the 51 does. Just depends on how much damage hinders them two cars.
I guess you can say he may be down, but he's not out, thanks to that caution. It is only a one car difference. And it says he's currently 24th.
Yeah, great. Mr. That higher position that they were before the yellow, or actually that's exactly where they were at before the yellow. Well, the problem is they got damaged now, and all the other competition was just filler cars, really, for the championship battle. But there's also, you know, season standings implication for those other guys as well.
Yeah, because those guys who haven't had a win yet, or at least have one win, they just want to win the last race.
Yeah, 100%.
It's the last race of the season, and as I said earlier, some guys may be gone, some guys are going to new teams, so at least we'll put that on their resume. And I believe some are staying with the team they've been with for a while.
Yep, Road Tracing, they've been with them since the start, I believe in 2021. Actually, no, it might have just been last year, I could be wrong. I don't remember, but I know they made it round of 8 at one point, I think last year, and this year they made the round 8, and now they're in the championship 4, and currently leading the championship battle, and they've, from what I'm aware, been doing the all race with no issue the entire race, and it's not over yet. They're still got a decent, Brock Nelson has not really lost a whole lot of ground on him, but you know, it's going to be something to watch for sure.
I'll tell you one thing, they're slowly making their way to the front, even though they have damage.
Well, I think they're just picking out cars that are a little bit slower than them right now.
Yeah, currently in the 12. You can see Nelson in the background. Six laps to go.
Have anyone like 30 seconds? Okay, so.
What? The 30 car is like 24 seconds back.
They're just trucks big. I think we'll be safe from them.
It's a big wide track with 6 laps to go. I don't think anyone's going a lap down anytime soon.
Some dance is so pretty far wide in the 1, trying to get some more spots. There's Marker Leonard. He's got a good bid for right now for the most laps led. Just doesn't look like he has any damage, but he just lost a lot of spots on the pit road, and now he's just not. He's at a very big disadvantage.
I think he might have lost the draft as well.
Yeah, that's also a teammate to the 63 of Sumdan, so of course he's going to go ahead and let Sumdan by, naturally, so helping out his teammate.
I mean, that means Sumdan moves up to 19th, and
Nelson hasn't gained much.
He's losing a lot of ground now.
He's losing a lot of ground very fast, that 51 car. So at this rate, since I did not turn on my EXE, if we have a yellow late in this race, it's going to end under yellow, because I don't have my checkers on. So what happens, happens. Unfortunately, what happened did happen. So we didn't want to see that, but it did. Oh, it looks like the 83 very slow on the back straight.
Whoa! Okay. Just barely got the way.
They have not had
very fast. He's doing like 189, so.
Yeah, he is
probably
going to pit road, because he is really slow right now. That 83 car.
Yeah, he is way off pace here, but he decides to stay up. As long as he's out of trouble.
Sandman
is making his way up to his currently 18th with three forwards left to go.
Well, once he gets around, if once he gets around this 97, I think that's it, because there's not any more cars to pass really in front of that. I mean, there's a few more, but they're way ahead. I don't think he'll catch him. But some Dan has still got the faster car than a lot of these guys. Even off a raw pace, we've seen that 66. I don't think they got any damage anywhere. I could be wrong. Same for the 97. Again, I could be wrong, but the 63.
Yeah, yeah.
The rear end damage may actually be a slight advantage. I say slight because they weren't able to keep up with the draft at the beginning of the restart. Once they got this thing going, now they're in a little bit better shape.
With two laps to go,
someday
he's
been trying to do it for a couple of years now. Road racing, trying to do actually something funny. They would be able to win the last. Okay, so they. I don't think they do have a possibility to win the last race season, but some Dan trying to get road racing their first NCCRS championship and his first NCCRS championship. He's got one more time around in that damaged number 63 Kestrel Dodge. The white flag's out. Current race leader is it's Riley Gorse in the 16. He's currently the race leader. We'll take a look at him. He's across the line. Sixth flame trying to get one more spot ticked off as Brock Nelson doesn't have much. Unfortunately, the tragedies of this race, not great. We're not going back here, but I think we got ourselves a deserving champion who's worked very hard at it. And the circumstances really just been the best car all day, even before all that rigmarole happened under pit road. And
I don't see Brooke Nelson anywhere, so he's, yeah, I don't see him at all. But a few last quarters are away. And your champion is going to be Sundan. It's your 2023 NCRS champion, as I think the 99 Potato Boy will win the last race of the season.
Yep, third win of the season for that 99 car. Very strong appearance this year. Be very strong next year. We're not going to get much next year, so pure skill is going to be the name of the game. So if he's still running in here next year, he's definitely gonna be one to watch.
So Potato Boy gets the win, and Sunday is your champion.
Yep. Well, we usually end these off by saying we'll see you next race, but next race probably won't be filled till February. So I want to thank all our commentators this season: Dark X Rain, Reggie Fogelman, Cactus King, Vince Freeze, Eric Monaco. If I'm missing anybody, let me know. I think we had Jonah Burridge and we had Potato Boy come in a couple times, and I think we also had someone else. I can't remember. EGEE. Not a member of the series, but he did come in and commentate a race for us once, or with us once. Bobby Isaac, helping us commentate as well. Again, if I miss anyone, just know it's because I am a terrible league owner, and my memory is not as good as it used to be. But
I think Jack has been here. John also been here as well. Eric Monaco was one of our commentators.
Didn't have exactly the race we wanted, but at the end of the day, you hit and miss, and this is one of those misses that we won't be repeating, as this track won't be returning next year. Cup's probably going to run this track. I'll just have to take what we incorporated here and tone it down some and kind of repeat it for the Cup series. Hate it for everyone involved in all those wrecks. Even I think all four of the championship war drivers are involved in the wreck, pretty disappointing, but congratulations to Sumdan. He's had a great season. Finally got that elusive championship he's been looking for. And as for me, all the people who support this, everyone watching, all our subscribers at Zek103TV, be sure to like and subscribe if you haven't. You're lame. And I think that's going to be it. We'll see y'all next year at, I believe Daytona is going to be our NCCRS season opener. And you'll have a happy off season. And Dark, you got any last thing you want to say to the viewers before we head off for our winter off season?
Well, I know the off season is going to be busy for the next season of NCCRS. We'll see you guys in 2024. And that's mostly it for today. And our last race of it will be the CCS.